Everyone who works with a financial advisor has a different reason for doing so. But one of the most common reasons is to provide you with tax management services. With that in mind, you need to pay special attention to this video because I'm going to tell you about one of the best tax preference savings vehicles that's available to you today. If tax management is one of your primary concerns, the best and first place you might want to consider for tax preference savings is a health savings account, or HSA. Why do I say this? Well, because an HSA is the only triple tax-free option available right now that gives you a tax deduction going in, tax-deferred growth along the way, and tax-free distributions on the back end. Keep in mind, the distributions must be used for qualified medical-related expenses, but it's a pretty good bet that virtually everyone will incur at least some medical costs in the future. The key here to maximizing the HSA for savings is to pay all your actual medical expenses as they occur out of pocket, while at the same time contributing to the HSA for future medical expenses. This allows the HSA the time and potential to grow tax deferred and tax free in order to leverage these benefits even more in the future. In this way, the HSA becomes kind of a supplemental retirement savings account where the money is earmarked for tax-free distribution of funds for your qualified medical expenses in retirement, including some of the long-term care expenses and insurance premiums. I think that's pretty cool. And once you establish your HSA, you can reimburse yourself on a tax-free basis for any IRS-qualified medical expenses you incur from that point forward, directly from the HSA, even many years later. So, of course, an HSA is only permitted for those who already have a high deductible health plan, one that satisfies the minimum deductibles and maximum out-of-pocket costs. And you need to know that the sweet spot for HSAs as they relate to retirement savings age is 65 or older, so not to be confused with the 59 and a half for IRAs. So 65 or older for HSAs. And if you withdraw funds at any age for qualified medical expenses, you'll pay no taxes and no penalties. But if you take money out of the HSA for any other expenses, the withdrawals will be subject to taxation and you'll pay a 20% penalty if you're under the age of 65. So yes, there are some caveats. The HSA or health savings account is just the first of several ways that individuals and households can build tax preference savings. I'll tell you more about the others in the future videos, but if you don't want to wait, just give us a call. We're always here to help.